This is no longer the Locked On Coyotes show. This is the Locked On Logan Cooley show. Hit it.
Your Locked On Coyotes, your daily podcast on the Arizona Coyotes. Part of the Locked On Podcast Network, your team every day.
Welcome to the show, everybody. This is Locked On Coyotes, your number one daily podcast on the Arizona Coyotes. I'm your host, Robin Leonio, alongside Matthew Jacobson. We want to thank everyone for making this show your first listen every day. We are free and available everywhere you get your podcasts, including on YouTube and the SiriusXM radio app. We got a great show on that today's episode because last night, Matthew, the Arizona Coyotes
took the win over the Los Angeles Kings in Melbourne, Australia. All right, you can jump in anytime, but like once again, this is the Logan Cooley show. This is all we're talking about today. It's all we're talking about tomorrow, and the day after that, and the day after that, and the day after that. And if the team ever relocates, we're still talking about Logan Cooley. It's just the Logan Cooley show. Take the mic away from me.
The Logan Cooley show. It's gonna be all Logan Cooley because look, as it shows on our little notes on the side, Logan Cooley is the savior, confirmed.
Yes, Logan Cooley, the best prospect in hockey. Logan Cooley, he's better than that bust Bedard. Like, who even cares about that kid? That kid, Peter Mueller is better than Connor Bedard. We're talking about the best prospect in the world right now. And that is Logan Cooley, who, look, I've seen him live, and everyone knows, all right? I was fixing something on the main concourse when he scored the lacrosse goal. He scored the Michigan at Mullet Arena. So I missed that live, but that is still a ridiculous highlight. But it's like, oh, it's just against college kids. Dog, this is on the stage, all right? It's preseason. Shut up. All right, literally, there were two NHL squads, and he made them look ridiculous.
Yeah, it's preseason, but we're talking about a preseason game, in which is practically the final roster. Mm-hmm. And it's again in front of over 13,000 fans in Australia.
Mm-hmm. It's Cooley, Cooley, Cooley.
I don't know what other way to put it. He is just that good. Like, I saw him, like, you know, I was watching the game, you know, back and forth on while I was working, because I had to work last night. Mm-hmm. But luckily I convinced you know, the manager to turn on the Coyotes game in the bar so I could watch the game, and I got a chance to see that. Like, I saw bits and pieces, but like I that's one of the things I saw. I'm like, oh my god, Logan freaking Cooley.
Yeah, no, we had to make that shirt, except for we'll put the real word on there, but we can't say
the real word. Yes,
not a Locked On podcast, but like someone actually added me. Was, oh, I can't wait for your recap video for that. And like, straight up, I was at Desert Diamond. I was working WWE, but more accurately, I was playing D&D while pretending to work. Like, I didn't get to watch the game. All I got was a flurry of highlights and, oh my god, Logan Cooley, this and that, and my jaw dropped. And then I watched it again, and my jaw was still dropped. And then I watched it again, maybe another time, maybe a fifth time.
If you follow the show on X, you'll know that we posted a GIF of his goal. So if anyone can say, I'm pretty sure anyone can now save that GIF, so you can use it to your own pleasure.
We gotta make it like an emoji or something, like a whatever for like the chat. Like, it's Logan Cooley. It's the Logan Cooley show.
It is the Logan Cooley show, and I'm officially gonna need to change the display name on X to the Locked On Logan Cooley.
Yeah, or even just Locked On Cooley, because it still fits. Instead of Locked On Coyotes, it's Locked On Cooley.
There we go, Locked On Cooley.
like how ridiculous is that play? I have the notes here, so like after the break, we will talk about, you know, the stats and the play-by-play stuff as much as we possibly can. But we need to just Logan Cooley on the forefront here. How the hell? What the hell? I don't know what I watched. I've seen some ridiculous goals. All right.
If you didn't watch it, we'll try to explain it as the best we can. Coast to coast, through the needle, spinorama, diving goal.
Like, all the buzzwords we got. Every single one. I'm just smiling and nodding, but it was an EA NHL goal. You know those really hacky, like, EA NHL goals that you see on highlight reels or whatever? Like, people are usually laughing because they're trolling. That was it. Logan Cooley did it. He did it in a real game.
I said it on the those that are going to watch the show, watch the Locked On NHL national show on Monday, we'll already know, like, yeah, I was asked, you know, the expectation probably that's going into Logan Cooley. Calder Trophy, here he comes. Like, come on. Like,
Sweeps. Who's even going to compete? Again, Connor the Bus Bedard, who's got the former MVP on his line that couldn't help the Coyotes win? Come on. I'm joking, by the way. There's probably at least three or four people that are just, like, seething watching this. I'm messing with you. Anyway, it's Cooley to lose.
He just does not have the support that Logan Cooley has.
He doesn't have a Dylan Gunther and Jason Zucker on his line. Maybe he has a Jason Zucker. Maybe Taylor Hall and Jason Zucker are the same player. Maybe. All right, production-wise, somewhere in there. But, like, you don't have the explosiveness. You don't have the ability to go up to play with Schmaltzy and Kells whenever you need to. If he's going to be getting power play time, that's probably who he's going to be playing with. I would assume. No, it's a lock. This kid actually has a supporting cast. Bedard is very good. Give it a couple of years when he gets a supporting cast. This kid is ridiculous. Again, Locked On Cooley. That is it. No more. No mas, no less. I don't know how to say less in Spanish. No mas, no less.
No menos.
No menos. No mas, no menos.
I love it. But you're right. You're right. But we're going to continue this episode of Locked On Logan Cooley in just a little bit. But first, we do need to take a quick break to hear from our sponsors on today's show. And today's episode is brought to you by Bird Dogs. Are you tired of sacrificing comfort for style when it comes to your activewear? Introducing Bird Dogs, the game changer in athletic shorts. Picture this. Premium shorts designed for maximum performance combined with unparalleled comfort. Bird Dogs are here to revolutionize your workout routine with a unique built-in liner. These shorts offer the ultimate support and flexibility, ensuring you stay comfortable even during the most intense workouts. And here's the best part. Bird Dogs are more than just workout gear. They are versatile enough to take you from the gym to the street without skipping a beat. Designed with pockets that actually work, Bird Dogs give you ample space to store your essentials while you're on the move. Bird Dogs made a premium, breathable fabric that keeps you cool and dry throughout your activities. Perfect for the trails, the gym, or simply just lounging around. Bird Dogs are the shorts that you have been searching for. Order your pair of Bird Dogs today and enjoy the thousands of satisfied customers who have made the switch. Visit birddogs.com/lockedonNHL and enter the promo code LockedOnNHL and get a free water bottle with every order. Bird Dogs, style meets comfort, performance meets perfection. You won't want to take these shorts off, we promise you. So, Matt, let's continue to talk about the game in Australia. You know, as much as we want to talk about Logan Cooley, other stuff happened. The Coyotes won 5-3. Great game.
Didn't I say the over-under was like over 6 points? Didn't I say that?
So, if you listen to either of our betting advice, I picked the parlay. You just said the over, right?
Yeah, I said the over, and then I jokingly said, like, Carconi to score the first goal because, we never have, like, the standard first goal score, and it was Clayton Keller, so I was wrong on that.
Yeah, but... I said, I mean, if you wanted if you parlayed my picks or if you just made them separately, either way, you cashed in because not only did I say, you know, agree with you, Matt, on the over of that 6 points, but I also said pick the Coyotes in the money line. The Coyotes were not favored. The Kings were favored. I said pick the Coyotes in the money line and cash in. What a game it was.
Maybe I should have actually bet. Like, Just for context, I've been covering the team since 2018, 2019, and I got so good at covering them and, like, knowing what's going on that there was at least a couple of reports I didn't watch the game. I just had the notes. And because I was so used to how they played, I could give an accurate account of what happened without watching the game. So, like, this is, like, second nature. It might be a cheat code. Like, maybe I should bet on the games.
I actually, like, kept, like, I think one of the seasons, I forgot which season, I kept a record on all of my betting picks on this show. Mm-hmm. And there was still a couple I lost. It's going to happen. Hockey's stupid that way. But I still ended the season, the full season, with a winning record on betting picks.
W's. Anyway, we legally cannot give you betting advice, I don't think. I think there's a licensing thing for that. But, I mean, like, you can probably trust us at this point. I think we've done just enough.
We specifically won't tell you to make that bet, but we will tell you what we are betting.
Or what we would theoretically bet, because she asked me and I took the over. I took the Coyotes and guess what had happened.
Exactly.
Minus the Carcone thing. I think him and Nick Bame were scratched, weren't they? So that last line was Boyd, Kerfoot, and O'Brien?
Yeah. Hey, you still got another game anyways.
Yeah. So, I mean, hey, there you go. Didn't watch the game, and I still keep up on the facts. Let's go goal by goal. You want to go goal by goal?
Let's go it.
All right. So, the no scoring in the first. The second period, a minute, 48 seconds in. Kells finds the back of the net from Schmaltz and Durzi. A little bit later on, almost exactly 7 minutes later, Michelli is first from Valimaki and Zucker at 8:22. Adrian Kempe answers back about a minute later. Who really cares? Because Krauser, they left him wide open. That was right in the, not the slot, it was like in the center between the circles. And Bukestad finds it. It's 3-1 at 11:19. Then you have that masterclass by Cooley at 11:40 from Mosier and Gunther. A couple back-to-back goals to end the period for the Kings. Once again, no one cares because Barrett Hayton, his first from Kells and Schmaltz. I'm assuming that's an empty net. Yeah, empty net goal with about 22 seconds to go for a final score of 5-3. And where is the shots? It was listed as 36-20, but when I was watching Shannon's recap last night, the NHL app was apparently broken, and the shots were not accurate almost the entire night. So, grain of salt. Coyotes 1-for-2 on their power plays. LA 0-for-4. So, keep that in mind. The penalty kill at least stepping up to an extent. And then I did overhear that Durzi had a pretty bad turnover, but he's playing against his former team. He's used to passing to the Kings. That's also a stolen joke, but hey, it works.
So you know what's really interesting? When Cooley scored the goal to go up, was it 4-1, right?
It was – the Cooley one was 4-1, yep.
4-1, yeah. I was like – I saw that and I was like, all right, Coyote's got this. I'm not too worried. I'm going to go, you know, finish up my work in the bar. Mm-hmm. And then, like, after I finish, like, stalking the bar, I get – I look it up and it's 4-3. And I'm like, what just happened? And then I didn't even see the game finish. I just saw a shootout and I'm like, wait a minute. What is happening? They went to a practice shootout just for the heck of it. But like I was so confused for a second. I was so confused. I'm like, what is but I eventually realized, oh wait, no, it's just a practice shootout. Okay. They're just having fun.
But like seven goals in the second. They hit the over in one period. Seven goals in the second period. Are you kidding me? Who would have guessed that? Who guessed?
Especially since like the first period was nothing, practically. Mm-hmm. Like, so.
Are we also going to compliment Josh Brown dropping the gloves out of the penalty box?
Hey, you always love something like that.
Browner actually goes for the fights. I gotta respect it. Like, he's a decent defensive defenseman. Then he goes out there like, I'll just go punch people in the face.
The fans in Australia getting a chance to watch the first preseason game in the Southern Hemisphere got themselves an actual taste of good classic hockey. Got the awesome goals, the sauce, and he got the fights. So
And Craig Morgan said that they were chanting, "Let's go Coyotes."
That is the apparently in an Australian accent too, and I really want to figure out find the video for that so I can actually hear what they sound.
Because what would that sound like? Because like I can't map like, you know, like down under, but like to Coyotes, I can't map that in my head. That sounds weird.
I know, right?
But it makes sense. There are probably Coyotes in Australia, and also like I saw a tweet. We're not going to say who the tweet was from. It was like, oh, why didn't they send a more important team? Dog, the Coyotes are the most important team in the NHL. Like, they are always in the news cycle for every little thing. Like, almost more so than Toronto.
In everybody's head because everyone's talking about them. And that's, you know, and that's why. Also, you know, it's grow the game. It's grow the game.
But also, like are we, like, it's no wonder the Coyotes weren't paying their bills. They're so used to living rent-free, they probably actually thought they could.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
I am fired. You will not see me on the next episode of Locked On Logan Cooley. Robin will have to take it from here and see if Carl might want back on.
Let's also talk about one of the other things too that happened in the week leading up to it, the ice issues that was going down over at Rod Laver.
Couldn't be Mullet. That wouldn't happen at the Mullet. The Mullet wouldn't have puddles everywhere.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. The Mullet Arena has some of the best ice I've ever skated on, and it is even confirmed by NHL players. Like,
it's great. It's very good ice. Secondhand information. I've been on it, but I never got to skate on it. You could put two and two together.
Now, just get some rental skates and at least skate on the on the community sheet.
Well, I'm only ever really there for work, so like because it's such a far drive, it takes a lot for me to want to be there super early, right? So it's like I just kept my skates in my trunk now. I keep the Kyle Chipchura skates in the trunk, and hopefully they won't break apart. If I try to skate with them, because those are old. Like the screws are brown. The screws are rusted.
Yeah, maybe you might need some new skates.
I got some new skates. I'm just protective of them.
But yeah, I mean, no, that was really interesting that it happened, you know. But hey, you know, we're talking. Yeah. Things happen, right? Things happen. But once again, outside of that, though, in the game, what, 13 over 13,000 fans, right? Sellout crowd. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I saw a comment too on that same thread that you were talking about earlier, that that said it's okay because people in Australia don't care about hockey anyways.
They sold out. Then again, this is the same people that wrongfully claim Atlanta didn't care about hockey. Like, they were never in the bottom of the standings as the Thrashers. I can't speak to the Flames. But they were never in the bottom of the attendance, and the team was never good because the ownership wouldn't let them be good. Like,
yeah, no,
that,
yeah,
they always do this.
The Atlanta Thrashers were just a poorly run team. They had the fan base. The fan base is there.
Look at the Gladiators. Look at Thrasher's Night. The amount of like, do you know how expensive Thrasher's jerseys are now? And it was filled with Thrasher's jerseys? Get out of here. Atlanta likes hockey. Australia clearly also likes hockey. All right. Just because it's not Toronto, does not mean they don't care about hockey or won't care about hockey.
Yeah. Hey, and the thing is, even those from Toronto love coming down south to enjoy the weather.
How about new rule? Just for Toronto, actually, any Canadian citizen, you're no longer allowed in Arizona. No more. No mas.
I mean,
hate it so much. Go away.
A lot of the people that I talk to when I'm at work, a lot of the guests that come in are from Canada.
Boo! Are they riding their RVs, causing traffic jams and 10-car pileups on the 10A?
Come on! They're actually, you know, they're really friendly people. I will give them that. But
most Canadians are friendly. Doesn't mean I like them. I'm neutral too. I'm joking. I've gotten in trouble before. Some people take me too seriously. I'm joking.
Partially.
Mostly. I am mostly joking. Mostly. I've met plenty of very nice Canadians. All right. Shane Doan's Canadian. They can't all be bad.
Exactly. Anyways, let's keep going though, because they've got another game tonight, right?
Mm-hmm. They got three tonight.
Yeah, they got three tonight, including the game in St. Louis, which I think is probably already done by the time this is posted.
It'll be done when it's posted, but we're recording right now and it's live. Before we went live, it was in the second period, so I can actually look this up. It's 3-0 St. Louis in the second intermission. The goals went to Bushnevich, Sundqvist, and Kyrou. Who is in goal for the Coyotes? The Coyotes have... Oh, this is still St. Louis. Excuse me, never mind. The goaltender is Volalta, who is not having a very good go of it. And the notables I'm seeing on this roster are Ulevi, who is a -2, Onyebuchi, -1, Lang Luol, who somehow is neutral here, Lombardi, Tyson, Nate Smith, Cameron Hebig, Zach Sanfertz, that's a pretty good person to go throw back in St. Louis, and Ryan DeZingle. So hopefully the third period they can bounce back, but there you go. Is your live, not so live update?
Not so live. Live on the show, but not live when you when you're here.
They're gonna be like, "Oh wow, no, they finished. They came back. It was a 4-3 victory. Lombardi had a hat trick. What are you talking about, AZ? You dumb, you dummy."
All right, let's keep going because I'm gonna go head right back to our friends at the FanDuel Sportsbook. And bring us back up to the odds for tonight's game in Australia, the second game in Australia. Because why not?
Give me the odds. Let's do another bet and see if we can win.
All right. So the Coyotes are 1.5 underdogs with the odds at -165.
Mm-hmm.
If you choose to bet them on the money line, plus 122, it's -148 if you choose the Kings. Total points is at 6.5 at +100. Over -135 under.
Jack McBain sweeps. That's all I got.
This is a little more of a tough one. Because I don't think it will be the exact same result as last time.
I mean, it might be a close game.
I will say, take the points for the Coyotes. I won't go money line this time. Take the points at the +1.5. This one's also going to go over.
God, it is so weird. The Coyotes are playing today, but it's listed as tomorrow because it's tomorrow in Australia.
Right.
And at 8 p.m. we get the Wichita game local time. I don't know. You know what? Since I have today off, I might actually get to watch the Wichita game.
There you go.
I got some stuff to edit after this. I'm not watching a 3-0 blowout, so
we're gonna watch both games.
I probably can today because it's funny. 2 days ago, we're in the Five Below parking lot hanging out with my wife, and we're eating dinner, and she's like, "Oh, you gonna watch the game tonight?" I thought she was talking about the football game, which I thought was weird because she doesn't like football. She thought the Coyotes game was 2 days ago, but because of how it works, it was actually like one day off. But even though it's today, the game counts as tomorrow, and yesterday's counts as today. And you guys are going to be confused because this might go up today, it might go up tomorrow. So there's a lot of confusion when it comes to different time zones. The NHL Europe will never be a thing. Like anyone that thinks we're going to do NHL Europe or NHL outside division, not going to happen. It's already too confusing. This is a preseason game.
Oh, yeah, no, the time zones are just so out of whack. I can't do this. I mean, we previewed it as Saturday and Sunday, and I'm like, oh wait, because we're on the West Coast, it's technically Friday and Saturday,
even though like legally it's Saturday Sunday. And
even if you're on the West Coast, it's Saturday and Sunday because if you're on the East Coast, the game starts at midnight.
I hate it here. I don't like having to think, all right? My Digivice watch is a 24-hour clock, and I have to add to try to figure out what time it is. I don't like this. Where the hell did that watch go, anyway?
Anyways, though, so did you make your picks?
Jack McBain sweeps, Cooley assist, Coyotes win. Screw it, 4-2.
4-2. So I'm gonna go Coyotes in the money line and under 6.5.
Sure, because like it's pretty logical to assume that game one's everyone's a little more like stiff. Is the best way, probably like the best way I can think of to describe it. It wants to be a little more loose and a little more like kind of in their own game at this point for game two. So I feel like it'll be a little more defensive, a little less surprises.
I mean, to the Kings' credit, I feel like, Phoenix Copley has shown to have some, shown some, bright stints over the last season. So, maybe he'll have a good game against the Coyotes and it's a low scoring game. Who knows?
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe he sucks.
Or maybe, yeah. maybe Logan Cooley will just be Jesus again.
Yeah, we're going to start. Well, we can't call him Mick Jesus. We can probably call him like Cool Jesus. I think we're going to coin it here at 1:54 p.m. Arizona time on September 23rd, 2023. He is now Cool Jesus.
Cool Jesus.
Oh, we're going to get an email for that one. I don't care. It's worth it.
Anyways, any final thoughts before we close things out?
I want to do the sign off for the first episode of Locked On Cooley, if that's okay with you.
All right, let's do it.
All right. Thanks for tuning in to this episode of Locked On Cooley. Make sure to like, comment, favorite, subscribe, and all those fun stuff. We're available everywhere podcasts are available, like Sirius XM Radio app. That's a pretty good one. And you can check us out on Facebook, facebook.com/LockedOnCoyotes, or at the app formerly known as Twitter, onesinglex.com, at @LO_Coyotes. Robin is personally at Robin_Leonio. I am at the AZ Sports Guy and Cooley. That's all I got.
Well, that's it for the show. Thanks again, everyone, for listening. Hope you guys are staying safe out there. Hope you guys are staying healthy. And don't forget
to Cooley!